Dear students, in this video, I am going to cover the next feature of page formatting. This feature is inserting a page break. Page break means if you want to change the page, like means when you start typing text in your document, at the time it shows only one page. And then if you want to insert another page, then you use this option. Page break, and basically this option is used for multi-paged documents. In multi-page documents, the text flows from one page to the next page as you add information. And how to specify this page break? How to apply this page break? For this, you go to Insert menu, then click on Page break. Otherwise, you can use shortcut key Control Enter. Click on page break. Now it is showing another page and the cursor automatically placed on the next page. And if you want to apply other types of break, then you click on insert, then more breaks, then click on manual break. And this manual break, it displays one dialog box, and this dialog box contains three types of option: line break, column break, and page break. And to apply line break, what we have to do, you click on this line. See here, the cursor is showing on the first line. And if you want to change the line, you can change your line by pressing enter key. But if you want to apply this option, for this you open manual break dialog box and then click on line break. In this way, line automatically changes. Otherwise, by pressing enter key, line automatically changes. Now, the page break can also be narrowed down to the line and column by using manual break. For this, you open this dialog box, that is manual break. Then you click on column break. You can use column break means you can divide the page into columns, and means you can apply page break, line break, and you can use shortcut key for this. And means in this type of break, you have to break the page forcefully. Means here the page automatically doesn't change. Means when you start typing text on your page, and if your page full of your text, then automatically the cursor goes to the next page. But this page break option applies for forcefully change the page or to insert the next page in a document, and it takes the cursor to the next page to insert the new heading. This is called as page break. Otherwise, you use these three options for different type of break. Thank you.